You may have seen a recent news story about a team of Japanese and German researchers who wrote a program to simulate the human brain.
Brains.
And in fact, their program didn't simulate the entire brain, just 1% of it. Now, 1% of the brain is about 2 billion neurons and 10 trillion synapses. Every synapse required about 24 bytes of storage. I think you can imagine that 24 bytes times 10 trillion is a lot of bytes. Now, suppose I gave you a computer workstation with 16 gigabytes of main memory. Here's my question to you. How many of these 16 gigabyte machines would you need to store a full model, that is, all 100% of the brain? Now, suppose the DAG has work W of N and span D of N. The ratio of work to span, or W divided by D, has a special interpretation. It basically measures the amount of work per critical path vertex. So think about that for a second. At every critical path vertex, there's an average amount of work. So this ratio basically tells you the average available parallelism in the DAG. Remember, our original question was to get an upper bound. So can we get an upper bound on the sumand? Now the floor of something is always less than or equal to that something. Haha, that gives an upper bound and eliminates the floor. Oh no, I'm falling into a pit. Okay, this looks a lot cleaner. Now you just need a little algebra and the fact that summing all these WKs will give you W. And putting that all together, you get your first interesting result. Congratulations. This is Brent's theorem.